early pioneers put this place on the map, and ever since aviation began, aviators have been flocking to this iconic destination. They have some pretty major events here, and when they do, like the Birdsville races, the population swells up to several thousand, so we really need to know what special procedures are in place. The guy behind the bar, he's our refueler. He's the guy with all the information. Let's find out what he has to say. Hey Darren, how you going, mate?
Yeah, good, mate, good.
Yeah, that's good.
Nice.
Must be a busy man running between the airstrip and the pub.
Yeah, it is quite busy from time to time, yeah, absolutely.
Birdsville races, they come to town. There must be a frenzy around here, is it?
Yeah, there's people absolutely everywhere. A lot of people start turning up, you know, 3 weeks prior to the event, from campers to people flying in aircraft.
So how many people would fly in for an event like this?
These days it's about 100 to 120 planes.
Especially when there's a big event like the Birdsville races, are there special action plans or anything that happened during that time?
Yeah, look, we like to have a steady flow of traffic when they do land. So it is important all the aircraft get into the same flow, especially when they're taxiing up to get avgas.
How do you feel working in such a place on the end of the Birdsville track?
Yeah, it's quite special, I think. This place is on a lot of people's bucket lists, so people spend a lot of time and money to get here. You never know what you're going to see in this town.
Whatever your mode of transport, whether you're on two wheels or whether you've got the Forby, or whether you're using a set of wings, this place is absolutely extraordinary. Birdsville is one of those places you have to see in your life. And with all the history around it as well, Burke and Wills, you know, you've got Tom Cruise and the Mail Run, it's a beautiful place. It's warm too, let me tell you, it's only gonna get warmer. G'day Dan, how you going?
Great, how are you, Pete?
Good, good. This is one of the camera bags.
Mind if I just have a quick look?
Yeah, knock yourself out. Yeah.
So what else you got? Oh, you got some cameras,
some
batteries.
The batteries. I've covered the contacts and put it in a little bag, is that all right?
Yeah, that's exactly as I described, and it looks like you've done a very good job. There's no metal exposing on any of the contacts, and the bag should stop any fumes getting out and into the cabin.
How easily could that happen?
These batteries are notorious, the lithium batteries, for overheating and potentially exploding and giving fumes into the cabin.
Okay.
You can chuck them back in. Yep. We'll just make sure we put them at the front, just in the event anything does go wrong with them, that the crew or yourself can access them.
One of the great things on the CASA website is the Dangerous Goods app. Can I pack that? They'll let you know what you can or can't take on a flight. Go to the CASA website.